Welcome to the session on Excel Foundation. In our today's session, we are going to see how we will protect our worksheet, right? And also we will see how we will be working with the workbooks and how we will be protecting it. Protecting means what? When you are having any confidential data, you should have some authorized access, I can say. Simply, in other words, I will say that we should allow only the validated people into your workbook, into your worksheet, I can say, in order to edit your data, in order to delete, in order to insert the data, we need to allow the authorized people so that your data will be validated, your data will be in a safe manner, I can say. In order to do so, in our Excel, we will be having two options, like protecting our worksheet and protecting our workbook. And along with that, we can hide the worksheet. Already we have seen in the previous session, if it is a confidential data, if it is a private data, then you can go for option called hide. But whatever the hiding option that we have used previously, there we are having unhide option also. But in today's session, we will see one more hiding option where you people will be having double hiding, I can say, or as very hiding, I can say, where you can hide the actual sheets and it will not be visible when you are unhiding the general sheets. Okay, now let us start the session. I will open a workbook and we will be working onto that and we will be protecting that and how it will be protected, what are the options that it will disable, that is what we are going to see in our today's session. I will open my Excel sheet. So I will go for book 2. Okay, here I am having some data and see already this workbook is protected. See, generally when we have opened with one workbook, then you can see here in my sheet 1 tab, I am having a shortcut menu like this, where I will be having the options like insert, delete, rename, move or copy, view code, protect sheet, tab color, like this, we will be having a list of menu. But when I am protecting my particular worksheet, when I am protecting my particular workbook, then I will be disabling few of the options from here so that it won't allow you people to insert the sheet, it won't allow you people to work with a new sheet, or else it won't allow you people to delete the sheets. Okay, now let us understand. Here in my workbook 2, I have protected my workbook. For that reason, when I am going for the sheet 1, when I am clicking on the right button of your mouse, then it is disabling options like insert, delete, rename, move or copy, tab color, hide, unhide. All these options are not available. Why? Because this workbook is protected now. How we will be protecting the workbook? Just see here. I will go for book 1. See, this workbook is not protected. That's the reason it is allowing us to do all these things. Okay. In order to protect our workbook, we need to go for review tab. Observe on your display. Go for review tab and go for changes group. In that, protect the sheet, protect the workbook. Okay. You can share the workbook also. That we will discuss later. But our topic is to protect the worksheet or protect the workbook. I'll go for workbook. Okay, you will be having the restricted editing and unrestricted access and manage credentials. If you will be having all these options, go for protect structure and windows. There you people will be given with two options, protect workbook for structure and windows. You can go for structure and I will be giving some password. When I'm entering the password, it will ask us to re-enter the password so that when you want to unprotect your worksheet or as workbook, it will ask you people to enter the password. Enter. See here, it is asking us to re-enter the password to proceed. Okay. Click on okay. Okay. See here, now I'll go with the sheet tab and I'll right click on it. See this, it is disabling all this options. Okay, like this you can go for. And when you are going for protect sheet, it will allow you people to modify the permissions that you have taken away from your worksheet. See here, these two are already allowed. Formatting cell is not allowed, formatting columns, formatting rows, insert, all these are not allowed. When you want to make them happen, then just click it on and click on OK. Okay, like this you need to do the things. Okay, I hope it is clear. Then see here, and again we are having one more sheet 2, and I'm right clicking on this. Here also it is not displaying all the options. Why? Because we have protected workbook, not worksheet. That is the reason it is working on the other sheets also. Okay, clear? When you are going for workbook and protect structure, just I will go with, see here, in the previous case we have dialog box like protect workbook. Here we are having unprotect workbook. Why? Because second time when you are going for, then you want to unprotect it, then just press your password or else enter your password and click on OK. Now it is unprotected. See here, all the operations can be allowed. When I want to go for sheet, then I will go for review and protect sheet, and I say some password and click on OK. And again it is asking for the confirmation, click on OK. Now see, on the sheet 1 I will be having the same options, on the sheet 2 I will be having the same options. Why? Because it is individually working on the sheet, it won't work on complete workbook. Okay, unprotect your worksheet, just go for your password so that it will be unprotected. Like this you can protect your worksheet and unprotect your worksheet. Okay, and see, visibility mode is one more option where you can go for view code. Okay, see here, I'll go for the sheet tab and click on view code. Here in this, you people will be having the properties option. Okay, properties, Windows F4. Okay, here you people will be having visible. Here you need to select very hidden. Okay, this is visible now. You can hide that worksheet and you can very hide the worksheet. Just click on this. Okay, and just see here, already one sheet is hide. Like this you can very hide the worksheets. Okay, and when you are pressing Alt F11, directly it will be open. Okay, directly it will be open. Alt F11, do remember the things. Just like this you people will be hiding and unhiding the worksheets. Right, in this session we have seen two options, like very hiding the sheets and protecting the workbook. I can say in our review tab you people will be having a protect sheet and protect the workbook options like this. Okay, so do remember them. Sometimes in your competitive examinations they may ask you people, in which tab we will be having an option called protect workbook or protect worksheet. Okay, do remember them. And we have seen the visibility option. In some situations you people will be having developers tab option, there you people will be having the visibility option also. This is it for now. I hope it is clear to you people. If you are having any doubts, just let me know by your comments so that I can clarify you people, and we will move for the next topic. See you in the next one. Thank you.